Okay, so hello everybody. I'm the Java trainer at SP Global Solutions. Okay, so today we'll discuss a few interview questions from a real-time point of view. Okay, so I'm just sharing my screen. Okay, so generally when people do attend for interviews and all, okay, quite common there will be questions from a real-time point of view. Okay, so we thought we'll just share a few of those real-time questions with you people so that it will be a good preparation for you to attend next time. Okay, so first if you see, what is the meaning of open source technology? Okay, see, this is very quite common question which in every interview it is asked. Okay, so if you see the answer, okay, any technology that provides source code also to the general public. Okay, so actually, right, the Java programmers which we write the with Java programmers which we write the code in the Java files and all that, we call it as a source code. Okay, see, if you take the Java software, okay, if you want to run any Java applications on our devices, either laptops or PC, we have to download and install the Java software, isn't it? So when we download the Java software from internet and all, even the source code, the code which is actually used to run the Java software, that is also provided to the public. General public by whom? By the Oracle company people. Okay, so any such technology which even provides the source code to the general public, that kind of technology we call it as a open source technology. And yes, Java is called as an open source technology. Okay, let's see the next question. What is the meaning of lightweight technology? Okay, so this is also a very common question in each and every interview. Interviewer will definitely ask this question. Okay, so what is this answer? If you see, any technology for which if the source code occupies less memory on the servers. Okay, see, just now we were talking about source code, right? Okay, the files wherein we actually write the source code. Okay, if you see our Java applications, when we develop the internet-based applications, okay, what we do, all the source code files we put it on this server. Okay, so that client can access. Okay, so when we actually put these source code files on the server, the source code files should occupy less memory on the server so that the server memory will be freed and server CPU, it can process very fast. Okay, so if you take the Java technology, the source code of these Java files, they occupy very less memory on the server. Okay, there are technologies which are called as heavyweight. That means the source code of those files, they will occupy more memory on the server. Okay, so any technology for which the source code of the files, if they occupy less memory on the servers, we call it as a lightweight technology. Okay, and yes, Java is called as a lightweight technology. Next question, what is the meaning of IDE? Okay, so this is also very quite a common question which very many interviewers ask. Okay, see, as soon as we tell what is the meaning of IDE, the answer will be yes, it is an integrated development environment. We get the answer. Okay, but what exactly is that? What do you mean by integrated development environment? What is that meaning of that? Okay, see, if the answer, if you see, okay, integrated development environment is an application. Okay, it is a place or an application to code the programs. If you want to write any Java programs and all, any code if you want to write, okay, so we need to write in some place, right? In some files we have to write. Okay, so that kind of application or that kind of file where we actually write the Java code, it is called an IDE. Okay, generally when we ask this question to people who are attending interviews and all, what is an IDE? They say example for IDE, if you ask, they say Notepad, Edit Plus, these things. Okay, but in real time, if you take in software companies and all, nobody uses Notepad and all. People use all the real time IDEs. Like we have so many IDEs in the market. Like we have Eclipse, we have My Eclipse, okay, we have IntelliJ IDEA, we have J Developer, and many more IDEs are there. Almost Java supports almost some 14 to 15 IDEs that are available in the market. Okay, so they are the IDEs that in software companies it is being used by the developers. Okay, then we have a next question. What is a compiler? Okay, so if you see the answer, compiler is a tool to compile the programs. We know, right? When we actually want to run the Java program, we have to run which program? Normal standalone programs. Okay, we in Java we have, right, standalone applications and programs. We have web applications and programs also we have. Okay, standalone means those applications which will run on one particular machine. Okay, on one particular PC or laptop. There is no web application, no internet, nothing is required for that. Okay, so any application which runs on one particular PC or laptop, we call it as a standalone application. Okay, so if we want to run any standalone applications, definitely if you want to run the program, there are two stages to run. First, we have to compile the program. Second, we have to run the program. So if you want to compile, who is the one which will actually compile? Compiler. Okay, there is a tool by name compiler who actually will compile the program. Okay, what do you mean by compiling? Compilation is nothing but checking for the syntax error and all. Okay, so there is a tool by name compiler. Okay, this tool, it comes automatic once the Java software is installed on our PCs. We don't have to install this compiler tool separately. Okay, once we download and install the Java softwares on our PCs or laptops, okay, compiler tool also will be coming by default with that. Okay, so compiler is a tool which will actually compile the program for checking the errors, okay, syntax error and all those things. Next, what is an interpreter? Okay, so just now we were saying, right, if we see the answer, interpreter is a tool to run the programs. Just now we saw, right, compiler is a tool to compile the programs. Okay, after compilation is done, we have to run the program. Okay, so if you want to run a program, two stages are there. First, we have to compile. Second, we have to run the program. Okay, compilation, it will be done by the compiler. And if we want to running the program, it is the one that is done by the interpreter. Again, what is an interpreter? Interpreter is also a tool to run the program. Actually, the interpreter name is JVM, which stands for Java Virtual Machine. Okay, so this is the one who actually runs the program. Okay, so again, this is a tool that comes as part of the Java software. Okay, we don't have to again separately install this tool. Okay, once we install the Java software on our PCs and laptops, okay, automatically interpreter also will come, JVM also will come, so that we can run the programs. Next question is, what is meant by portability? Yeah, this is a very good important question which many interviewers will ask in the interviews. Okay, so if you see the answer, okay, it means the ability of software to be carried to other devices and operating systems. Okay, meaning software to, okay, when we develop a Java software on one particular device, operating system, okay, we can easily carry this particular having one Java software or application to other devices which are having different operating systems. For example, if I develop my Java software or Java program on Windows, for example, operating system, I can carry this Java program like Linux. Again, I have to do it. So what exactly of setup there? So portability is not the ability of a software to be carried forward. Okay, if we can carry a particular software or a program from one device to other device and from one operating system to another operating system. Okay, so that kind of a software, that kind of a program, we call it as a portable. And Java programs, yes, we can develop in one operating system. We can easily execute as a. Next, we have one more question. Can C and C++ code be integrated in Java? It's also a very important question. The answer is yes. Why not? Okay. Yes, if there is a code which apart from Java, if there is any other code that has to be programs, yes, Java will do that one. Okay, we have one good feature of Java, right? Dynamic. So what exactly when we say dynamic? Dynamic means during running of the program, if Java programs need any other classes and their objects too has to be loaded, Java will load those classes and objects automatically and continue with execution. Not only Java classes and objects, even if there are objects of other technologies like C++, if the objects of those technologies also have to be loaded during running of the Java program, yes, Java software, what it will do, it will actually load the objects of other programming languages also like C++, and it will load into the Java program, then it will continue its execution. Okay, so the answer is yes, other code like C, C++, it can be integrated into Java technology. Okay, so these are the few questions which I thought I'll be sharing with you people. Okay, maybe next time I'll be sharing few more questions with you all. Okay, so that's it for today. Thank you all.